Hey guys, so today we are going to be creating some basic typography kind of designs by placing text inside a path and just kind of seeing what we can do to make it fit into certain kind of boxes and stuff, right? So let's go ahead and get a custom 5x5 or however big you want your thing to be. And let's see if we can't think about how we might set up kind of a layout of, say, for instance, I don't know, some kind of a flyer, some kind of a information card. Usually they tend to be more rectangular in shape, but say for instance this is just a little thing we want to put down, right? So anytime you press like your text tool here, it automatically creates this filler text. So if I were to create this this big box here, oops, that. If I were to create this big box with my little text tool selected, it'll fill it up as much as it'll go with the various filler texts. This is just a Latin kind of nonsense. I imagine it means something. Those of us who take Latin can obviously tell me I'm wrong. but a couple things to kind of keep in mind whenever you're typing, what we're using this tool, is that you have the same kind of alignment tools you have down here. So for instance, we have left align, center align, right align, and then we have justified with a sort of right align here. And you notice a couple things change, both the spacing between words changes, and sometimes the spacing between letters change. So for instance, if I were to kind of put this in, you see here like the tracking changes between the characters and stuff. So same thing here, we have the justified with the center align, justified with the left align, and then finally we have justified across the entire paragraph. So all those are just useful tools to kind of keep in mind. I'll get rid of this right here. But a neat thing about this is that we can create different shapes, and we could actually make our little outline here. So for instance, maybe I just want to like create a basic outline here. So I'm just going to go, I'm going to go over here, and I'm just going to make a little rectangle across the top here. And I'll see if I can't, first off, make it have a stroke and no fill. So I'll just have it be blank and fill it with just a single stroke. And I'll just align that to the center here. I can probably just grab this instead of pull it up to the center right there. Okay, good. All right, so that's centered thereabouts. And maybe I can kind of pull it up a little bit more. That's fine. Okay, so with that done, maybe what I'll do is I'll just hold down Alt and I'll just drag this down. I'll just keep it centered, hold that out again, drag it down, and maybe here what I'll do is I'll just create a little circle about yay big, or square about yay big, and maybe over here I'll create a little circle. Here, I'll just make a little circle here. All right, so obviously you can just create your little arrangement of shapes in any way you'd like. I'll make sure I can center those here. Okay, so we've got these two shapes here. I'm going to see if I can't make it just quite the same height here. I'll make it a noble instead. Okay, so let's just start off by doing this. I'm going to select this square here. And then, so before I get my text tool, I'm going to select that tool right there. And I'm going to click on my text tool. And you'll see a little dotted circle up here around the little cursor bar, the little I-beam there. So I'll click on the little cursor there, and it'll automatically fill that entire shape up with text, with that same filler text, and it'll allow me to start typing. So I'm going to start typing here. I'm going to put my caps lock on. I'm going to sort of type something across the top. I'll say something like things that are important. And what I'll do is I'm just going to make this as big as I possibly can here. So I'll make this, big enough to where it just fills up the entire thing. I'm going to change the font too. Change the font to something other than Myriad Pro, please. That's an order. All right, I'll choose Lumen Milk. And I'll just make it a bit smaller so it fits in. All right, so obviously you can, from there, just hit these little arrows. You could also type in different numbers. So for instance, if you want it to be like, instead of 24, you can say 23.5. Or six or whatever. So the whole idea is that, remember, points are their own unit of measurement. It's not the be-all, end-all. So there's 72 points in an inch. There's really 12 points in an inch, and then there's several pixels in a point. So if you want to change it to a different unit of measurement, like picas, you could. Okay, and so down here, what I'll do is we have good text there. I'm just gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna click on this shape here. I'm gonna click on my text tool, and I'll just click here with my text, and I'll just use the filler text there, and I'll make it a little bit smaller. I'll make it say, for instance, this big, and I'll let me actually do that one more time. Let me just undo that. And first off, let's do this. So it automatically has the text that you selected before. So I'm gonna make sure this is down to, like, say, for instance, 14 points, or maybe even, like, you know, 10 points. Oh, 14 points, that's good for now. And I'll just change it from lemon milk to something more like Verdana or something a little less less decorative. And I might even take this this right here, and I might just kind of pull this up a little bit, like so. And I could take this text tool and just once again hit that path, and it fills that up. And I'm going to get rid of this last little bit here, and I'll just make sure it's justified. And I want to say you have the option of hyphenating your letters, so I'm going to click off hyphenate, so that way we don't have little hyphenated letters there. So there's little three dots right there next to a paragraph. You can just click on that, and you can decide whether or not there's a thing. So down here we have various things like indents, and then we have you know, first line indent. We also have space before paragraph, so you can, like, kind of put little gap in between it. So for instance, let's just double click on all this stuff, and we'll just gonna pull this up some. Well, obviously there's no room for that there, but so that's a thought you can have there. Okay, so we'll just do the same thing down here. Say for instance this is by, like, main thought here, and so I'll go down here and I'll just click on this one. I'll click outside here and I'll just change this down to something like 10 points instead of 14 points. I'll say 10 points. I'll just click right there, and we'll have a little block of text right there. And then we'll do the same thing here. I'll just click on this, and I'll get my text, and I'll just fill it up like so. And so there it is. It fills up that circle with text. Now, what's great about this is that because we have these things sort of grouped, it automatically forms its own kind of design here. It automatically forms its own sort of the shape is there, despite the fact we don't have any lines. So that's part of that whole good continuation, good form. We can kind of see in closure, we can kind of see where the borders are based on this. Now, obviously, if you kind of zoom out a little bit, it might get easier to see. If I were to, for instance, make this a bit smaller, like, say, for instance, pull this up a little bit here, right, you can probably see it even better. And then from there, we can kind of just look through here. We can see maybe we can, like, lay this out so we can, like, put this more between these two. The gap between the top of the page and the bottom of the page and the text is a little bit different, so I might want to pull this down some to where it's more you know, even. So I'll put that down as well. And we can kind of see that things are starting to look a little bit better just in terms of where they're placed. So I'll get rid of this text here. And this right here is good to use, for instance, if I want to place this on, like, a different background. So for instance, if I wanted to maybe put, like, a gradient in the background, so let me make a new layer here. I'm going to make a new layer, and I'll just make a background. I'll just fill it up with I'll just get a square across the whole thing. Let's, like, I get this rectangle tool with a square across the whole thing. And I might make this, look at my properties, look at my fill, look at my gradient here, click on my gradient options. And what we'll do is we'll change the radial for one. It's just going to be lighter, so I'll click a light color. The outside is going to be darker, so I'll click a darker color. Okay, maybe not quite so dark. And we'll put this in the background here. And we'll take this text, and we'll just select the entire layer. And we'll change the fill to, say, white. So good, very good, you know, ways of utilizing this text, right? So if you want to somewhere on this little document here, put your name on it, you can. So I'll just, like, take my, you know, maybe, like, I'll say things that are important, you know, to Mr. Lobello. And maybe even center this right here, like that. And then I can take this down some. So make sure everything fits. If ever you you know, edit one thing, you have to kind of edit everything else to make sure it fits in. And I'll just fit this in right here. Make sure this is right. Let me get it closer. Oops. All right. So very cool. So that's essentially how you put text inside a path. And that's if ever you are doing copy fitting for a layout for a page, or especially a website, it's really important to have good layout. You can create your little boxes, you can create your little paths, and you can figure out where things are going to go based on that. All right, well, very cool. Well, you can make this layout particular here, or you can make your own layout, but can't wait to see what you produce.